Okay, well, I want to show you guys how to buy a car for less than $1 million and keep your cash. With the latest updates, you can't do this anymore with a car over $1 million credits because you can't gift them. But anything $1 million or under, you can buy and still keep your money. You're going to need two things. You're going to need a flash drive or thumb drive. And you're going to need another user account. The flash drive, just stick it in one of the available ports on the front of your PS3 console. And just make up a user account and a password. If you don't have another email address, it doesn't make any difference. Just make one up. I'll show you here. I'm going to use XTR Homer. And I'm going to sign in, and as you can see, my email address is biteme@biteme5.com. Now, my main account is Tallywhacker, and that's who I'll be sending the car to. And my email on that is tallywhacker@tallywhacker.com. So just make up an email address with a .com. Doesn't make any difference. It doesn't have to be legitimate. So we'll go back to Homer and sign in. And for those who say this is cheating, it is not cheating. In the past, from what I've raced and won, most of the cars and your payment isn't worth the amount of time it takes to win the car that you might win, or the money. So this is just a way to buy a car, keep your money, and send it to another account if you want. You can have it on both accounts, same car. Now just go ahead and get signed in, and of course you're going to have to send a request to add a friend to both accounts so you can be able to gift the cars back and forth. Okay, so after you get your other user account set up, if you don't already have one, first thing you need to do is go to the game section and scroll up to where it says saved data utility PS3, and that's XTR Homer. Hit the X button and you can see that's what I currently have. 7,471,000 and some change. So scroll up to your USB device and hit the X, and as you can see, I have the same amount. If yours is different, what you need to do is go back to the original game saved data, hit the triangle, and then hit copy. Now you're going to copy it to the USB device. Go ahead and hit the X and then yes, and now both your stick and the game data will have the same exact information. But you do this before you go in and get rid of the car. Make sure this is the first step that you do. Now go ahead and start the game. Okay, now once you get to this screen, go to the dealership or used car, whatever it is you're going to buy, and make the purchase. In my case, I'm going to go to the Lexus dealership. So now I'm going to buy the Patronus Tom's SC430. So go ahead and make the purchase. And after you make the purchase, go ahead and get into that car. Thank you. after you make the purchase, buy everything that you can buy for that car, because you're going to get your money back anyway. So first thing, you go into the GT Auto and change your oil. And if any of these options are available, go ahead and purchase them. Sometimes they are, sometimes they won't be. Then you want to go to the tuning shop. And I usually will get a set of sport tires. And I'll get, it'll already have the hard racing tires. I go ahead and purchase the medium and the soft as well. Now for this particular type of car, the only other things that are going to be available will be in the turbo section, and you have to buy these in order. And then up to your engine and purchase the stage 3. Okay, you've now maxed it out. And under the body and chassis, you can usually come over and get the chassis reinforcement. Like I say, purchase everything you can get, because it's not going to cost you anything anyway. After you've purchased everything, go to the garage. And as you can see, there's the car that you just bought and built. Now get into something else, anything, doesn't make any difference. Just change into another car. Now go back to the one that you're going to gift, and you're going to give to a friend. In my case, I'm going to give it to my other user account, Tallywhacker. Okay. That car is now in cyberspace. Next thing you want to do is quit the game. Now go back up to your saved data utility, and you can see it's now down to 6,372,000. So scroll up to the USB device, and that has the 7,471,000. Here you want to hit the triangle, copy, yes. And it's complete, and you just got your money back that you had spent. There's the game data back to 7,471,000, just like the USB stick says. So now you have made a purchase, sent it to your other account, and kept your money. Now you can go into your other account. In my case, it'll be Tallywhacker. And go ahead and start the game up. Now after you log into your other account and get to this main page, you'll see there'll be a red star in the community. Go ahead and hit the X button. And hit the gifts. Now, I've actually sent myself a couple of cars, but go ahead and click on the first one and click yes. So there's one complete. And I'll go ahead and open both of them. Then go back to the GT Life, down to the card delivery, and there's the two cars. Just go ahead and open them up and put them in your garage. And these can be sent back to your other account doing the same procedure. And that's how it works. I hope this helps some of you out. If you have any questions, feel free to ask or leave a comment. I appreciate you watching.